So rounded back deadlifts, let's talk about this so taboo topic that no one really knows what's going on, but everyone claims to be an expert in, right? So everyone thinks that rounding your back is instant danger, you're gonna snap your shit up, and that don't do it, rounding back equals injury. Now, before I continue, I'm gonna say that I'm not a physiotherapist and I have no formal training or education behind this. I'm simply a guy who did my own research and knows probably a little bit more than the average person. So most of you are probably really sensitized to getting injury because you felt pressure in your lower back when you started deadlifting. So you went on Google and you typed back pain deadlifts. And what pops up? Well, probably a post from bodybuilding.com has said that rounding back equals injury. So when any website presents you information that doesn't even have scientific research attached to it, always question it and don't just accept it as factual. So first of all, I'd like to talk about the actual resources we have available to us that can help us make a decision. So there's this pretty good post that actually has scientific attachments to it. It's not just some broski bro talking his head off. And they're not my arguments, so you're not taking these broski arguments for myself. We're actually going to use these arguments that actually kind of make sense. And yes, this is biased to my understanding because this is the best information I have seen so far. And if you have any better information, drop it below in the comment section. I'll definitely take a look at it. So while deadlifting or lifting in general, disc herniation is the main concern in the lumbar spine. So in this article, you see that disc herniation is a part of normal aging and that you're not just going to get it from injuring yourself, but it's also part of the natural process of getting older. So included in this article, there are four main types of motion, and that's flexion, extension, rotation, and lateral flexion. But we're mainly concerned with flexion as that's probably where we're going to get our lower back rounding from, right? So oftentimes when you hear disc herniation and deadlifts, you're going to hear neutral spine. Is your back neutral? And pretty much this is a zone of where you're most stable and you can take the most load and range of motion. But just because you're in the neutral spine zone does not mean that you're safe for injury. And if you look in this article, it says that, quote for quote, "Their results demonstrate that the neutral spine is not safe from injury. In fact, the neutral segment experienced a higher percentage of disc failure during both impulse and gradual pressurization." Dumbing this down, you're not safe just because you train with a neutral spine from injury. It also states that discs also have a capacity to adapt, strengthen, and heal over time. So that might suggest that having a certain amount of preparedness when you're lifting makes a big difference, whether you're going to get an injury with the lower back or not. So the next part where I thought was really interesting was under the considerations. Many of us have seen that one guy who can bust out rounded back deadlifts without any issues, and most people also have known someone who seems to injure their back every other week. And they have a study which compares 45 pairs of twins with different exposures of flexion. But pretty much what comes out of this study is that disc herniation is genetic based. And if you look at myself, I'm not trying to stroke my ego or anything, but I'm probably a genetic anomaly for injury's sake in my lower back. And speaking out of anecdotal experience, I have never hurt my back doing a deadlift. I actually hurt my back multiple times squatting and benching even. And deadlifts have exacerbated the pains I had, but from a direct injury from deadlifts alone, I have yet to do that. Knock on wood, let's hope that never happens. So just because you round your back does not mean you're going to get injured. Now, do I recommend rounding your back while deadlifting? Well, that's ultimately up to yourself. And given my anecdotal experience, rounding my back has allowed myself to get the bar closer to my hips and to cut some range of motion, ultimately making me a more efficient lifter for powerlifting. And that is the reason why I do round my back. But if you notice in some of the clips I posted earlier on this video, my rounding changes throughout my training, and that tends to get better, and I tend to strive for a flatter and more efficient pull just to be safe.